Nonviolence is not merely one way to peace. It's not merely one of the paths or one of the options. Nonviolence is the only way to peace. Tragically today, all over the world, people seem to believe that one can use force, aggression, to somehow beat people into peace. You can beat people into submission, but submission is very different than peace. If we want to have peace, the only way to attain it is through nonviolence. Whatever we plant, that is what our harvest will reap. If I plant an apple seed, it doesn't matter how much I love peaches or how many peachy songs I sing or how much I pray for peaches. If the seed is lost, I am only going to get apples. There's no possibility that I'm going to get peaches out of an apple seed. If what I want are peaches, I have to plant peach seed. And in the same way, if we are planting seeds of violence, planting seeds through aggression, through exploitation, through violence in our thoughts, our words, our deeds, how in the world are these seeds of violence going to sprout into trees of peace? We have to plant seeds of peace. As all of our revered speakers have said, it must begin with you. The only way to attain peace is to begin from within and then spread out. Our desires and our greed are the greatest obstacle to this. They convince us over and over again to crave more, to yearn for more, to die for more from the outside world. And as we expect more and crave for more, naturally, we end up frustrated. They convince us that the key to our own peace, the key to our own joy and bliss in life, somehow lies in things outside. But if I just get a new model car, if I just have a home in this area of town, if I just have this brand of jeans or this type of mobile, somehow I'll be happy. There's a wonderful story of a woman who's searching in the road in the middle of the night. She's down on her hands and knees under a streetlight. And a wise man walks by and he says, "Mother, what are you searching for?" "Oh," she says, "I've lost my key." The man gets down on his hands and knees and he helps her look. And after a short while, when they haven't found it, he asks her, "Mother, where did you leave your key?" "Oh, in the house," she said. "Well, then why in the world are you searching for it outside in the street?" And she says, "Because it's dark inside. I have no light. Outside, there's this very bright street light. So I thought, let me come outside and I'll search for it where it's bright." He said, "Go back inside. It may take you a little while, but you'll find the key." And we laugh, because who in their right mind would possibly search outside in the road for something that's inside? And yet, that's exactly what we do in our lives. We spend our lives searching. We search in catalogs, we search in shopping centers, we search on the internet for the key to peace, the key to joy, the key to meaning in life. But it's only within ourselves. We'll never find it outside. And so we become more and more frustrated, We acquire more, we attain more, we buy more and more. We change our brand of cars, our brands of jeans, but we still don't have peace. The top medicines prescribed in this country are antidepressants, anti-anxiety medicine, sleeping pills, and Viagra. This is the country that has attained, achieved, acquired more than anyone else on earth. And now we have to take pills to do what animals can do. A pill to go to sleep at night. A pill to drag ourselves out of bed the next day. A pill to convince ourselves life is worth living. A pill to procreate. Because where we're looking for that peace and that joy is not where it's to be found. So we're frustrated and we're depressed. Where is it? As Pujaswamiji said, it's only in that divine connection. Only when we go back within to that connection to the divine can we possibly hope to attain that peace. And I say this to you as someone who has come from this country. I've seen what this country and this culture has to offer. And it's not there. That doesn't mean don't enjoy it. Enjoy it for what it can give you. Comfort, convenience, luxury. But the key is not there. The key is in that connection. A man went to the doctor once, and he complained to the doctor, "Doctor, there's something very wrong with me. Everything in my body hurts. Whatever I touch, it hurts. I touch my head and it hurts. I touch my back and it hurts. I touch my knees and they hurt." And the doctor was amazed because usually people have one complaint. This man, everything hurts. So the doctor ran every possible scan and test. And at the end, he calls the man in and he says, "I have some good news and I have some bad news. The good news is, there's nothing wrong with your head or your back or your knee or your stomach. The bad news is, your finger's broken. And because your finger's broken, whatever you touch hurts." Different purposes, but that's what